Dr. Ben Neuman, head of the biology department at Texas A&M University-Texarkana, is so well respected around the globe that he serves on an international committee that actually named the latest coronavirus. He's being interviewed by news outlets in Asia, Europe, and the U.S. because of his 20 years of expert study in this subject.
I'm Ben Neuman, I'm from A&M Texarkana, and I'm a virologist. I started out in virology 24 years ago. I've worked with the coronavirus group at the University of Wuhan, of all places. I started out in the field before SARS was a thing, before MERS was a thing, before anybody really cared about coronaviruses. They were big and they were really neat. And since then, a lot has happened in the field, and frankly, I wouldn't be here today without coronaviruses. There are viruses out there all the time. If you were to put a glass box around 1 cubic meter of air, you would find around 1 million individual viruses in that. So every time we breathe in, we're breathing in something like 300, 500 individual viruses. Most of them just aren't viruses for us. Every virus has these little bumps on the outside, which are how the virus holds on to our cells. In coronaviruses, the bumps are a little longer, so they look like the points on a really fancy cartoon crown. So that's why they're coronaviruses, of which only a few cause human disease or even have the chance to. But there are a lot of these other ones out there, and they're all genetically related. Like, we all have relatives and we all share the same last name. It's that sort of deal. All the coronaviruses that we know are actually so diverse, so divergent from each other. These things are little evolution machines. They just go really fast, but do the same things that other living things do. So there have probably been viruses as long as there have been living things to catch viruses. Where they usually come from is other kinds of animals. You'll get things like bats. Turns out that every animal and plant on the planet seems to have about 300 different kinds of viruses, on average, that are just associated with that. And if you get those plants or animals next to something that's similar, then there's a small chance, but it does happen, that the virus can jump from one to another. And so that's what we're seeing. There are no new viruses in the world. They're just viruses that are moving from one host to another host. Coronaviruses don't really want to kill you, they really want to hide. And so they are very good at basically sneaking around your immune system and cutting all the wires that would let your body know that it's infected. You'll get the virus and the virus will go into hiding straight away. It'll turn off some of these alarm systems, and then gradually, over the course of about a week, you'll build up a greater number of viruses inside. Then eventually they can come out a little bit, and over the second week you might start to notice that you're getting a little bit sick. So mostly this would look like a fever and a cough, and the bottom of your lungs would start filling up with fluid, sort of the early stages of pneumonia. About a week after that, you'd be sick enough that you might need to go to the hospital, and then from the point where you enter the hospital, it's usually about 1 to 2 weeks to know whether you're going to make it or whether you're going to die there in the hospital. So the whole thing takes about a month. It's a very, very slow disease. When you get into a situation like this, where everybody is thinking about coronavirus and looking for some way to stop it, quarantine is the 100% effective way to stop absolutely any virus on the planet, and we'd be fools not to use it. Problem is, there's a lot of art in addition to science in making a vaccine that works. There have been quite a few experimental coronavirus vaccines in the past that have actually made the disease worse than it would be without the vaccine. So you have to be really careful, and there are a lot of great ideas, frankly, that have been tried out, and most of them don't work for one reason or another. There's a lot of trial and a lot of error, and we'll get there in the end if people focus on it enough and funnel enough money toward it. Ignorance is more widespread than the virus. Yeah, maybe less dangerous individually, but there's a lot of it around. And honestly, it's just people trying to understand a new, unfamiliar, kind of scary thing. I think context is what really makes a scary thing less scary. When you understand what's going on and why everything's happening, all of a sudden it makes sense. As long as we stay focused on it, keep our eyes on the prize, we can get rid of this thing drive it out of the human population. Because when the virus is in humans, this is a dead-end situation. The virus isn't going to go anywhere except in other humans. This is not how it normally replicates. Yeah, it doesn't need to be here, doesn't belong here, and we can get rid of it. Also, our immune system is great at its job, and frankly, that's what makes life possible.